Hey guys, today I'm going to be doing my out-of-box review for the SD Ex-Standard Sinanju. So, love or hate the SD Ex-Standard line, one thing that can be said about them is that their details are nice, and that they're definitely cheap. So that's good, but of course they are very sticker heavy, even more so than regular SD kits, and they do have some hollow spaces, but in this case, the actual hollow spaces are not that bad. There are some glaring ones, but I think overall not as bad as previous ones, and the details on this are great. The stickers are not that much. There is a lot of color apps that are missing, both just in parts and in stickers, but that shouldn't come as too much of a surprise. Obviously with any SD kit you should be prepared to do a lot of detail painting because they can only be so color separated. But on the other hand, the stickers that we do have included with this kit are not as egregious as previous SD Ex-Standard kits have been. So I still think though, after building this kit, sorry about that, I still think that the Death Scythe Hell is still probably the one I would put at the best in this series so far. That and the RX-782 I think was also really, really great. But this one is also good. So let me give you a look around the kit here. The overall construction is pretty much exactly the same. So just the construction and the articulation is pretty much going to be the same as every other SD Ex-Standard kit. All the polycaps are the same and all of that. We do have the same hollow gaps in the back of the legs, but those are pretty well hidden by very large back skirts. Covers the majority of the back of the leg, and then we have those fuel tanks out the back as well, so I think that all that stuff going on in the back is gonna draw your attention away for the most part from the hollow spaces in the back of the legs. Plus 99% of the time you're probably gonna be looking at the kit from the front anyway, so I personally don't really find the hollow spaces in the back of the legs to be that bothersome. The one thing that I do find bothersome is the hollow spaces in the fuel tanks, which is apparent from the front. If you look kind of from certain angles, you can definitely see that the inside of those fuel tanks are very hollow. So I don't really know how they really could have done that differently though. So they weren't going to split those into two parts. They have a very limited part count for the SD Ex-Standard kits, so that just wasn't going to happen. The weapons are pretty okay. Do wish that we would have had the grenade launcher molded together on with the beam rifle, but we just get the beam rifle just by itself. I'll show you that in a moment. But just standard parts there. Unfortunately, no effect parts or like beam axe or anything like that. That would have also been cool. Maybe just as one extra weapon, just have one beam axe, even if it's just obviously no clear part. That would have been nice. But anyway, all right, let's get a look at the articulation here. So here on the head, you can see we've got a sticker for this gray piece on the chin, and then we have a sticker in there for the mono eye there in green. The head is going to be able to go up to there, down, to their overall really nice design. All the details and design of this head is all looking pretty nice. So up and down movement on the head is nice. Here on the chest we have just stickers, a few stickers making up that black and gold there on the chest, but goes on pretty well and I think looks pretty okay for those stickers there. For the shoulders we have the same polycap that just kind of swings out, but one issue that I've had with pretty much all of the Ex-Standard kits is that that polycap has a tendency to come out of the torso easily, so just be careful when you're moving the arm around and about. We have this separate piece on the shoulder which will move up just slightly, that moves just a little bit there, not really a whole lot, so the arm you're really only going to be able to move up to about there. Not a whole lot. Again, stickers here around the cuff that work pretty nicely. About a 90 degree bend there. Peg on the back of the arm is unsightly when the shield is not attached, especially because you have it on the other side as well. Kind of wish that they just didn't put it on this arm, but just cut that off and just sand that part down or something. Other than the wrist, just on ball joints, gray parts there for the hands. Couple more stickers here on the front skirts. This front skirt piece will move a little bit, but the way that it actually fits in this kind of with the tubing going around the bottom of the torso and into there kind of inhibits that movement a little bit, but if you're just going to move things around you can move that front skirt a little bit out of the way if you need, but probably just not going to bother with that at all. We do have a couple stickers there on the knee as well for more gold lining there, and then here on the foot a couple of black stickers there on the feet underneath the feet a little bit of detail there, but mostly pretty much just hollow. Again, the back of the legs, pretty hollow there. The one thing that I do mind about the legs is that this part here on the side, you can see like that's just kind of cut off where there should be like this whole part there. Kind of wish they just had that full part and that just wasn't like cut right down the middle of that. So that's kind of annoying. The back of the legs, I can deal with that, but this, I wish that that part was full and not just cut off like that. Empty spaces there inside the fuel tanks, that's what I've been talking about. These parts though don't have any hollow spaces. So this is just two parts that you just sandwich together for the boosters here on the back, and those are just connected on ball joints. Those can move up and down and a little bit side to side like that. The fuel tanks can't move at all, it's just fixed onto the backpack. And then the ankles can move up and down. The legs can move out to about there and down, and those are just on ball joints there up at the hip connection, so you can move those just a little bit, not a whole lot, but the ankles will point nice and far down, so that's nice. No problem moving those ankles down. Again, if you've watched any of the previous 12 reviews that I've done of the other SD Ex-Standard kits, the articulation is pretty much the same. So once again, for our accessories, we have the Sinanju's beam rifle. Here again, looks pretty unsightly with this peg there at the front, but you could just cut that off, sand that down. Very, very thin, and then also has these connection points here on the back as well. Yeah, I wish that this was a molded with a grenade launcher under there, but it's not, unfortunately. That just drops down into the hand. No problems holding that, and it's nice and long. And then we have the shield. Now this, again, is just made up of a few stickers that lay over this. Here's the one place where I found the stickers didn't work all that well. On the kit, the stickers all actually go on and fit and look pretty fine. Here on the shield, though, this one here, the way that sticker fits in, it's the lining looks kind of weird here in the center. You can see it gets really thin, and then it has to go flat again just because it's laying on a kind of flatter area. So that sticker, I think, was not designed properly, this long one down the center. Of course, mine is a little bit off-center there at the bottom, but that shouldn't really have that much of an effect here at the top. I'm pretty sure I have that on correctly. It's just kind of shaped a little bit odd. Anyway, on the back, just not really going to be a whole lot of detail there, just a whole bunch of connection points. It's not really looking that great, but this will just attach onto the back of the arm like so. And most of that stuff is pretty hidden there, just among all of this. And you just have this nice shield, but again, connection onto the back of the arm is not great. Wish it was onto the side of the arm, but unfortunately that's just how it works with this kit. Here is the SD Ex-Standard compared with the HG. Obviously going to be looking quite different there, and the HG, I gotta say, is looking pretty awesome. I love the look of the HG Sinanju. It's a really, really nice kit. I unfortunately don't have the RG to compare this with anymore. I gave that to a friend. Nothing against the RG, but just wanted to give that to someone who I knew would enjoy it more than me. The HG, though, I do still have here, and so I'm able to use this for a comparison here for you guys. But here for another comparison, just with another one of his SD Ex-Standard brethren, with the Unicorn Gundam there in Destroy mode, you can see they're going to make a pretty cool set together where, to be honest, if you want an SD Sinanju, the best way to go is just getting the BB Senshi Sinanju, just being honest with you guys. But if you wanted to have like a set of the Sinanju and the Unicorn, you could get both of these for the same price as the BB Senshi Sinanju probably. So that's just something to think about. Obviously, the BB Senshi Sinanju is nicer. But if you wanted to do like some diorama or something like this, you have to consider you could get like more for your money by getting the SD Ex-Standard Sinanju. So something to think about, I guess. So as I mentioned before, in terms of the accessories that you get with this kit, I really wish that we would have had a beam axe. Although one thing that has been kind of apparent with the SD Ex-Standard kit is obviously just the minimalism of them. Bandai is trying to keep the cost as low as possible with them, and that's quite obvious in terms of like hollow spaces and the very simple design and construction. But I think just throwing one more part on there just for a just solid piece of plastic just in the shape of a beam axe would have been nice. I guess, though, come to think of it, that wouldn't really be the hardest thing to just scratch build out of a piece of plot plate. Just cut that out and then just paint it. So I guess that's not too bad. But otherwise, I mean, it comes with everything that you would want. The details are all there. So if you want to just paint this up, Like all the details are there for you to paint it up in all the correct colors, painting in all the gray for the piping and stuff, and for the barrels of the Vulcans on the head, I think will definitely help a lot as well. And then you have just all the piping. As I showed in the unboxing, if you don't put the stickers on and you want to just do like a standard, like kind of reverse wash, which is what most people do for painting that gold trim on the Sinanju in any version of the Sinanju, that is totally possible with this kit. You can do that just in the normal way that you would, because all of that raised detail is there. You just paint it like you would normally, just with a reverse wash. You just spray the gold and then black, and then just go over that with a Q-tip to bring that gold back out. So yeah, overall, just it's a nice kit. It's not like fantastic, but it's not bad by any means. So that's pretty much it. And as I said before at the beginning of this video, I don't hate the SD Ex-Standard line at all. I think some people do, but I mean, I just see the SD Ex-Standard line for what it is, and it's, you know, for the most part, it's just cheaper, simpler models just for like the youngest of audience, just for like the most basic of beginner builders, and that's pretty much it. But I do also see a lot of potential in the line, is that just if you're willing to put in the extra work, a little bit of seam line removal, and a lot of painting, then they do actually come out looking like pretty cool kits. That being said, this I do feel like is a pretty unnecessary one, because the SDBB Senshi Sinanju is such a nice kit, and it's, again, like a lot of them have been, it's fairly inexpensive. So, I don't know, I love the Sinanju, and any other new Sinanju kits are always nice, but I think that they, I mean, something else I think could have been a little bit nicer, maybe doing something that doesn't have such a nice BB Senshi kit. But I guess pretty much all of the ones that they have been doing, because with the SD Ex-Standard line, they've just been doing like some of the most popular designs, so pretty much all of those are going to have just regular BB Senshi kits already. So I don't know. Anyway, if you wanted a cheaper version of the SD Sinanju, maybe you want to use it for a kit bash or something, then here you go. Here's a nice solid kit for you with some great details. Will be great for kit bashing. So that being said, if you guys have any other questions or comments, you can leave those down below. Otherwise, thank you so much for watching as always, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye bye.